بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. As we know and as we had last lectures that one of the main divisions of the paragraph is the topic sentence and it is the main sentence of your paragraph. And to focus on the topic sentence more and more and we should remember the conditions that we had for the topic sentence to be complete, to be clear, to be specific and to be well-worded, we should know the divisions of the topic sentence itself, okay, to have more and more details about the topic sentence. Okay. The first thing of the topic sentence, you have two parts of the topic sentence. That's number one, you have the topic, which define or which says your topic will be so and so. It defines your topic, okay? It specifies your topic. And also the second thing or the second part of your topic sentence is your controlling idea. Controlling idea. Okay, the topic tells what's your topic or what will you discuss. Okay, like English is my favorite subject. Okay, gold is a precious metal. Okay, this is the topic. Let's have it an example. English is my favorite subject. Okay, or another example. Gold is a precious metal, or air pollution has dangerous effects on the children's health. Okay, all these examples are good examples for a topic sentence. The first part of it is the topic itself, English, gold, air pollution. Okay, this is the topic that I will discuss. So it indicates or it specifies the topic or the main point of your paragraph. Then after it or after the verb, you have the other part, my favorite subject, a precious metal, dangerous effects on the children's health. These parts are the controlling ideas, the indicators of your discussion, indicators. Okay, you can say it is the indicator, an indicator, مؤشر. خلاص, it indicates what will you discuss, in what point you will discuss this subject. أنا هناقش البوث من ناحية إيه؟ من ناحية إن هو precious metal. Okay, مش من ناحية تركيبه, مش من ناحية it's mining, تعدينه مثلا. Okay, I'll discuss English as my favorite subject, not as a language that consists of so and so, or as a language that had developments, old English, Middle English, and then Modern English. No, I will discuss it as my favorite subject. Why I like it, why I like to study it and complete in a department of English, okay? I'll discuss air pollution, that it has dangerous effects on the children's health, not adult health, okay? So, this is the controlling idea or the indicator of what I will discuss in my paragraph. Okay, and when I divide, this is controlling, this is controlling, and this is controlling ID. And when I divide my topic sentence into these two parts, here topic and controlling idea, I can make a good outline for my essay and my paragraph. Consequently, my paragraphs, okay? And as a whole to my essay. لأن أنا لما أكتب كده my title here and then my topic sentence, my first topic sentence, this is the topic sentence of my first paragraph, then the supporting idea will be so and so, and the other supporting idea will be so and so, or the supporting detail or the supporting sentences. Then my second topic will be so and so. اللي هيحكم لي supporting ideas or supporting the sentences دي هي الكنترول. ان انا بناقش في اتجاه انها my favorite subject. بناقش في اتجاه ان هو precious matter. So it resists time, يقاوم الوقت والزمن مثلا. It's a preciousness according to the money when I can buy or sell it after a period of time. And so on. It is precious in, for example, in industry and in science. Okay, يبقى اللي هيشير ليا my discussion هتبقى فين بالظبط the controlling ideas. Okay, هنا dangerous effects on the children's health. هشوف أنا my topic sentence كده والcontrolling بالشكل ده. So I will discuss in my paragraphs or in my essay the effect number one, the effect number two, the effect number three on the children's health. Okay, يبقى هي الindicator اللي هتقولي what will I discuss. ودايما to ask yourself what am I trying to say. أنا بحاول أقول إيه. What am I trying to discuss. أنا بحاول أناقش إيه بالظبط. خلاص. Wait. Suppose for example you are lost. ارجع تاني to your thesis sentence الأصلية بتاعة ال introductory paragraph. This is for your essay as a whole. But in your paragraph قلت لك التورش. Your torch اللي بتنور لك المكان اللي أنت موجودة فيه. Your topic sentence. What am I trying to discuss in this paragraph? Okay. Also, in order to achieve the two main conditions of my paragraph, هتحقق لي برضو كمان الفايدة بتاعت controlling idea, the conditions of writing a good paragraph. For example, unity. As a condition for writing a good paragraph. Unity, for instance, أنا عندي كلمة unity. وعندي the other condition coherence. مش كده؟ مش دي من الحاجات اللي لازم توفرها في الباراجراف. يونيتي على فكره بالمناسبه النص بتاعها اللي هو يوني بمعنى one. وهنعرف ايه الفايده. كو بمعنى together or with. or with. تمام؟ الفيرب as a whole cohere اللي هي to hold together متماسك مع بعض. اوكي. ودي two of the main conditions of writing a good paragraph. ازاي topic sentence when I divide it into a topic and controlling idea تحقق لي these two conditions. هتبقى ازاي؟ اولا لما احقق شرط unity. unity بمعنى that my paragraph will discuss only one idea. my paragraph has a central idea, only one idea. It is only like a one block. Okay? If you extract it from your essay, you can understand an understandable idea of it. أقدر أفهم منه فكرة. Okay? يبقى أنا كده حققت اليونيتي. إزاي؟ لما ناقش gold, when I discuss gold as a precious metal or English my favorite subject, so I'll discuss in my paragraph only one idea that it is my favorite subject. اللي هي الانديكيتور قالت لي عليها. Or that it is a precious metal. يبقى انا ايه ناقشت حاجه واحده بس. So I achieved unity. خلاص my paragraph will be one piece or may will tackle only one idea, one central idea. Okay? This is unity. كمان هتحقق لي شرط الكوهيرنس. When I discuss gold as a precious metal, then it is كذا, it is used in industry and أو it can be sold in money or much money. It can be sold. This is coherence. My paragraph will be logically connected with each other. Okay. The movement between my sentences will be smoothly. Okay. وهيساعدني على كده حاجات تانية هتبقى assistant بالنسبة لي ان انا احقق الكوهيرنس بعد ما كتبت a good topic sentence inside my paragraph, inside my discussion. هتساعدني ايه مثلا اللي هي using اربع حاجات. Maybe using the nouns اللي هي الكي nouns. استخدم الكي nouns يعني اكرر. Gold is a precious metal. Gold is used for its utility or is used in industry and in science. Gold is كذا. I repeat the key nouns. اللي حقق الكوهيرنس. Number one, repeating the key nouns. This is number one. يبقى أنا كررت طول ما أنا ماشية في الباراجراف بتاعي. I discuss gold. 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 استخدمت نفس الكلمة. طب نقلت in another paragraph, the following paragraph in my essay, بستخدم gold another time for the key noun that I discuss. Okay, استخدم تاني نفس الكي نوع. طيب ممكن استخدم ايه تاني؟ consistent pronouns. خلاص ال pronouns استخدم pronoun بس ايه مناسب. استخدم pronouns اقول gold is a precious metal. It is used in industry and inside. It is used, but never forever begin your topic sentence with a pronoun. مش عارفة pronoun related to what. لكن inside my discussion, in my paragraph, I can use pronoun. بس يكون pronoun في consistent pronoun اللي هو مناسب لل numbers مثلا ما غيرش العدد. مش أقول هي وبعدين أرجع أقول زين على نفس الشخص. ما ينفعش. خلي البرونوم بتاعي suitable for your noun اللي انت بتتكلمي عنه او بتناقشيه. خلاص انا استخدمت انجلش ما ينفعش بعد كده هقول it. ما ينفعش بعد كده اقول زي. اوكي okay. استخدم بداله it as a pronoun. مش هقول زي ابدا never forever. لا اغير في النمبر في العدد ولا اغير في البيرسون نفسه الشخص. اوكي okay. مش هو مره استخدم it ومره استخدم بداله هي. مش هينفع. اوكي يبقى هستخدم consistent pronoun. الحاجة التالتة اللي تساعدني على coherence ويمكن دي قلناها قبل كده transition signals. transition signals and I share with you a paper for all transition signals or most of the transition signals. هبعتها لك. You can share this paper with your classmates. هنشوف فيها الأنواع types of transition signals اللي هما as a word and as a phrase. إزاي أقدر أستخدمهم sentence connectors and coordinate and so on. أقدر أستخدم transition signals إمتى؟ هتذكروها المرة دي وهناخدها المرة الجاية بالتفصيل in details إن شاء الله. أوكي؟ number four إيه ممكن أستخدمه كمان عشان يحقق لي شرط الكوهيرنس معايا؟ حاجة اسمها logical division. أوكي؟ logical اللوجيكال ديفيجنز دي عشان استخدمها ممكن I can discuss my subject in a chronological order بترتيب زمني الأحداث. That's the sequence of events مثلا. خلاص يبقى it depends on time الوقت اللي حصلت فيه الأحداث. بناقش بيوغرافي لشخصية معينة يبقى هو اتولد كذا and then he was راح كذا بعدين he was brought up in كذا بعدين educated in كذا so and so. اوكي يبقى انا ناقشت اللوجيكال ديفيجن يا اما عن طريق كرونولوجيكال اوردر. يا ناقشته بلوجيكال سيكونس اللي هو لوجيكال ديفيجن ان انا قسمت الحاجه اكوردنج تو لوجيك المنطق انها تقسم لكذا منطقيا ناقشتها لوجيكالي. اوكي logical يا اما according to its importance قسمت المقال بتاعي ان هو according to the important point, the most important point, and then the less important, the less important, the important, and the minor thing at last. According to the importance sequence. Okay, يبقى دي حاجات ادتني logical division. وأكوردنج تو الأورجانيزيشنز اللي كنا قلنا عليهم المرة اللي فاتت فاكرهم لاست ليكتشر لما قلنا في الكوز اند افكت مثلا كومباريسون اند كونتراست all these things give you a logical division to your essay and give you coherence. ما أنا بدأ بناقشت مثلا أكوردنج فور إكزامبل كوز اند افكت تشين أور بلوك فاكرينها المرة اللي فاتت لما شرحناها تشين أور بلوك this is هيجبرني إن أنا my essay will be coherent. كيف فانا مديه خطه محدده واتكلمت في ان هي اوكي اي ديسكاس سو اند سو ذا كوز اوف كذا اند اتس افكت اوكي اكوردنج تو تشين اور بلوك اولسو كومباريسون اند كونتراست اي ويل سي اور اي ويل ديسكاس اول ذا سيميلاريتيز اند ذن اول ذا كونتراستس بين تو ثينكس ذات اي كان كومبير هكتب لي نفس النوع فروم وان فيلد اي كان كومبير سو انا قلت اول ذا سيميلاريتيز اند ذن اول ذا ديفرنسز يبقى ده كل الحاجات all these organizations هتمشي لي my essay will be coherent cause and effect and also comparison and contrast. Will achieve the condition of coherence to my paragraph. أنا حققت الحاجات دي كلها my topic sentence as an introductory sentence and I divided it into topic and controlling idea. Then I wrote my discussion or body or the development of my paragraph. Then I should conclude my paragraph with the concluding sentence. And my concluding sentence should have or have three functions. My concluding sentence has three functions. لازم أحقق فيها ثلاث وظائف أو هي تحقق لي ثلاث حاجات ضرورية جدا جدا. It should be my last message to the reader. دهاني. Okay. It should summarize my main points. هتقول آخر حاجة أنا قلت إيه خلاص my main points and my discussion انتهت إلى كذا. It gives to the reader my result. وصلت لنتيجة ايه؟ اوكي؟ يبقى هي حققت لي ان هي as a summary to my paragraph كله على بعضه ان my paragraph discussed so and so. It gave my ideas or it summarizes my own ideas and it gives my last message to the reader and my result to the reader. Okay, this is the concluding sentence. بكده أبقى أنا كتبت paragraph well developed كويس جدا. Okay, with these types زي ما قلت لك هتساعدك في إنك تعملي a good outlining to your essay كويس قوي and then you can begin. يعني الحاجات دي كلها هتعمل لك مساعدة as an assistant or will help you in order to produce or to write a good essay وتقدر تقدمي في النهاية. مقالة تكون كويسة. لو مريتي بالمراحل اللي قلنا عليها the stages of writing when you practice writing more and more you will write at the end a good piece of writing. الحكاية دي بقى هتوصلك انك لما تتمرني مرة واثنين وثلاثة وتحاولي بالطريقة دي وبالطريقة دي وبالطريقة دي the stages of your writing process اكيد هتقدم ان شاء الله مقالة كويسة و a piece of writing, a good piece of writing at the end of your course. Okay? You can understand?
Yes.
Okay. Let's listen to your assignments بقى, your paragraphs اللي خدتوهم المرة اللي فاتت and your essay and let's have an open discussion. Okay.